An aortic aneurysm is a weakening of the abdominal aorta, which is the main blood vessel of the body. It tends to occur over time as a consequence of aging or of various diseases of the connective tissue disorders that help to build the structure of the aorta itself. Aneurysm in general usually implies that the vessel is dilated to over twice its normal diameter and usually is at risk for rupture or a tear that could cause significant injury to the patient. A thoracic aortic aneurysm is a bulging or weakening of the aorta within the chest. The aorta within the chest is generally about the size of a garden hose, but over time, with aging or structural abnormalities of the thoracic aorta, it can begin to dilate and enlarge towards an aneurysm.
It's not completely understood how aortic aneurysms develop. In some cases, it's related to a history of smoking. In other cases, it's related to genetic disorders such as Loeys-Dietz syndrome or Marfan syndrome, where there's an abnormal breakdown of the aortic wall, which results in a ballooning of the aorta itself. Aortic aneurysms are typically found incidentally, meaning that the patient didn't know that they had it. It can be felt on a physical exam in the abdomen as a pulsatile mass, or it can be seen on an ultrasound or a CAT scan.
An aneurysm within the chest, those being the thoracic aortic aneurysms, will give patients episodes of chest pain. The chest pain itself can be rather pulsatile in nature, a pounding sort of pain, oftentimes either on the front of the chest or between the shoulder blades towards the spine. In the abdominal aorta, the symptoms can also be quite diverse. But in general, usually it's low back pain or perhaps pain in the center of the abdomen. Again, quite classically, it tends to be pulsatile in nature or pounding with every heartbeat, more so than a typical ache and pain that one might experience with raking the leaves or shoveling too much snow. Smoking is the greatest risk factor both for the establishment of aneurysms as well as their growth once an aneurysm has been diagnosed. The correlation between smoking and aneurysm is quite great to the point that now, in the past several years, Medicare has allowed a one-time screening for patients at age 65 years of age who have a history of smoking to rule out an abdominal aortic aneurysm before, of course, it becomes symptomatic and leads to trouble.
People at risk for aortic aneurysmal disease include patients who are over the age of 50. It's more likely to be found in men than women, and it can also be found in certain genetic disorders such as Loeys-Dietz syndrome or Marfan syndrome.
The most common cause of aneurysms in general is related to smoking hypertension. We also are now beginning to understand that high cholesterol also plays a role in the development of aneurysms. At Hopkins, we have a very long and established track record of dealing with patients with genetic disorders which lead them to inherited weaknesses of the aorta as it runs through the chest and the abdomen and require surgery at earlier ages than we would typically see in patients who are smokers or who have high blood pressure who are coming to require aneurysm treatment in their 60s. Treatment from thoracic aortic aneurysms in terms of the threshold for which we move forward with a repair, whether it's an endovascular open repair, are different than those of an abdominal aortic aneurysm. Abdominal aortic aneurysms have been much more studied, and we have longer-term data to support the treatment thresholds that we use for the abdominal aorta. In the thoracic aorta, we generally draw the line at 6 centimeters to repair a thoracic aortic aneurysm, whether we're doing it with an open repair or an endovascular repair. However, if we see a thoracic aortic aneurysm is growing rapidly, such as growing 5 millimeters in 6 months or even a centimeter in a year, we may very well intervene upon that patient at a diameter less than 6 centimeters in size for fear that the rapid growth rate of their aneurysm is predicting a higher risk for rupture in the future.
Ultrasound is the most common screening test for abdominal aortic aneurysms. Once you get close to having an aneurysm that needs to be repaired, CAT scans are ordered because these tell us more definition about the anatomy and whether you're a suitable candidate for a minimally invasive endovascular repair.